Good morning, students. This is my 11th video lecture on Java programming. In this, I plan to explain about three different keywords: throw keyword, throws keyword, as well as finally. Okay. So we are having three different keywords that will be used in exception handling. So exception handling already we discussed in the previous lecture. It's a continue lecture and the end of module 3, end of module 3 we are discussing in this lecture. Okay, in this, the continuation of the exception handling, we are having three different keywords. One is throwing the exception from the try block, and throws keyword that can be written in the method can able to throw the exception, and then finally block we can write in the end of the program. Okay, so these are the three things we are going to discuss with use of a example program. Okay, let's see the first one, what we are going to do. The first one with throw keyword. Okay, so see the program. Throw keyword, we are creating a class named throw underscore example, throw underscore eg. Inside that we are creating a method that is a parameterized method, static void validate is the method name. Inside that we are passing a parameter int age, and inside the method we are having a conditional statement: if age less than 18, it will throw the exception. If age is greater than 18, it will print eligible to vote. Okay, so if age less than 18, it will throw a arithmetic exception, and it will print the arithmetic exception, whatever the exception statement we given in the double quotes, that will be printed in the output screen. Okay, then we are closing the method validate, and we are creating the main function inside the same class: public static void main, string args, validate of 13. We are passing 13 as a parameter for the validate function. So we are calling the function with passing 13 as a parameter. So it will call the validate function. Now the 13 will be passed to age. Age is 13. Okay. So if 13 less than 18, condition is false or true? Condition is true. Okay. So 13 less than 18, condition is true. So what it will do? It will just go to the if condition. The if condition is throw arithmetic exception, not eligible to vote. Okay, so that will be displayed as the output. That exception will be called. It will display as a arithmetic exception and display the content, whatever we given in the double quotes, that will be printed as output. Okay, if we are passing 19 as a parameter, validate of 19, it will go there to the method. There it will just check the condition: 19 less than 18, condition is false. So it will go for else statement and print eligible to vote. Okay, so throw, what is the throw will work? Throw will throw the exception from the condition and display the statement. Okay, display the statement what we are given in the double quotes. Okay, one more thing, down to throw, if you are written any other statements under if, for example, down to throw I am giving system.out.println, some statement I am trying to print, that will be not executed. If the throw is executed, it will terminate the entire code and display the exception and close the program. None of the statement down to throw will be executed. Okay, that is the working methodology of throw. Okay, throw can be written in anywhere in the program. It is used to handle checked exception as well as unchecked exceptions. Okay, so I hope you understand the throw keyword. Okay, let's move for throws, next one, that is throws. Okay, you have to understand the difference between throw and throws. Okay, throw you can write inside any code inside the program. You can throw the exception from anywhere inside the program. Throws is used for dealing with the methods. Okay, so when you are seeing the throws example, you can able to understand about throws keyword. Okay, so let's move for throws keyword. So this is throws keyword example. Let's see the program. class throw except. So throws exception, like that we are making the class name. Opening the class, we are making a method static void fun throws illegal access exception. Keep in mind the method itself throwing the exception mean by we are just judging that there may be exception occur inside the method. We are predicting that there may be a cause of exception inside the method, so that according to the method we are just making the throws keyword and writing which type of exception may occur inside the method. So we are judging that illegal access exception may be occurred inside the method fun, so that we are making throws illegal access exception. Okay, opening the function, we are just making a system.out.println method, and opening the system.out.println we are making inside fun. Okay, now next to that we are throwing the exception from the method throw new illegal access exception, then inside that we are making demo. Okay, so demo will be printed as a statement. So what it will print according to that, when you are calling the fun method will have a illegal access exception. Okay, so how it will print, it will just execute the first statement inside the fun, then when it see the throws keyword, it will throw the exception, that the illegal access exception, and print the statement as demo. Okay, public static void main, we are having public static void main. Opening public static void main, we are having try block and catch block. So try block, we are having calling off function, call off function we are having inside the try block. Catch, we are just catching the exception. Okay, so what we are doing, when you are executing this program, the try block will be, the main function will be executed first. Inside the main function we are having try block. So try block will call the method fun, so fun will be called, so it will print inside fun as a first output statement. Then it there is a throw of exception, so the throw will be catch by the catch block, so it will just print caught in main. Okay, so illegal exception access exception will be caught in main. Okay, so these are the outputs for this program. What you have to understand, throws keyword will able to determine whether the method having a exception or not, and throws will able to throw will able to throw the exception from the particular function or anywhere in the code. Okay, that is the difference between throws and throw. Okay, next to this we are having one more example on finally block. Final, okay, finally block, we will tell final is a keyword. So finally keyword, okay, that is meant by finally block. So here what we are doing in this, we are having try, catch and finally, three different blocks we are having. Try block, we are giving the code, whatever the code you want to execute. If there is exception inside the code, it will throw to the catch, and catch block will print the exception. And finally block will be executed when there is a exception or there is no exception. Okay, it will execute on both the times, mean by finally block will executed at every time. Okay, whenever you are executing any code, if you are having a finally block, that block will be executed at every time. Okay, so here class test finally block we are having. Opening the class, we are having public static void main. Inside public static void main, we are writing the try block. Try block, we are just doing a division operation, 25 divided by 5. So the answer will be 5, that will be stored in data. In the int data we are giving, that is the variable, resultant variable that we are printing as output. The 5 will be displayed as output inside the try block. Keep in mind there is no exception in this program, so that nothing will be called. There is no exception will be there in the program. If you are giving 25 divided by 0, there may be exception. The exception is said to be divided by 0 exception. Or if you are giving a string value, and if you are finding any length of the string, you will get null pointer exception. So according to this program, the program is fine, there is no exception in the program. So next to that we are having catch block. Down to the try block we should have a catch block. Then we are opening and closing the catch block. If there is exception, the exception will be printed by E, that is a object for the null pointer exception. Okay, next to that we are having finally block. So what the finally block will do, finally block will be executed. It will just print finally block is always executed. Okay, so every time when the program executes, the final block will be executes. So as of this program, the output is 5. 5 will be the answer for 25 divided by 5. That will be printed as answer. The 5 will be printed. Down to that, you will get finally block is always executed. That will be the statement from finally block. Okay. So these are the statements will be printed by this program. So I hope you understand try, catch and finally. Okay. These are three are the main things you may get in as a question in VTU examination. This is the continuous lecture with the previous one. These three things are deal with exception handling concepts. Okay, so next to this we are having exercise. See the exercise. That is only one exercise I gave. So write a program which has throw, throws and finally keyword, which handles any three types of exception. You have to write a program. That program must have throw keyword. You have to throw exception, and each function should throw exception, throws exception, as well as end of the program you have to write a finally block, and you have to deal with three different types of exception in your program. Okay, I hope you understand this lecture video. Just complete the exercise and send to my mail ID. Thank you. Thank you very much.